During that last apparition, a great miracle occurred, which was witnessed by 70,000 people, which has been called the miracle of the sun. Today is the 100th anniversary of that miracle. Before describing the miracle, I want to go back 3 months to the July 13th apparition, which is directly related to the miracle of the sun. After asking the children to make sacrifices for sinners, Our Lady showed them a terrible vision of hell, where the children were frightened to see souls and demons plunged in a great sea of fire. Why in the world would Our Lady do this? The people in that time and place understood this church doctrine very well, so there was no need to teach them anything. Well, the reason she provided this vision was to prepare the world for one of Satan's greatest deceptions, which was to convince people that hell does not exist. And the devastating impact of this deception has only increased over time. A recent study done by the Center of Applied Research at Georgetown acknowledged that 83% of Catholics believe that Satan is just a symbol, 83%. This naturally has led to a loss of faith unseen in church history. Rarely will you hear the faithful or even the church itself mention this dogma of the faith. It is quite clear that we are paying the price for the proliferation of communism and Freemasonry in the 20th century, which Our Lady specifically warned us about at Fatima. Okay, so let's fast forward 3 months to October 13, 1917, and Our Lady gives the world the miracle of the sun. 70,000 locals, academics, news people, and government officials witness the sun change colors and spin rapidly. Then they saw the sun tremble, shake, and finally plunge in a zigzag motion toward the crowd. Finally, it went back to its original position, much to the relief of the crowd. This all lasted about 10 minutes. What many do not know is that the young visionaries were oblivious to this miracle because they were seeing something vastly different. They first saw a joyful scene of the Holy Family, Saint Joseph with the child Jesus, along with Our Lady of the Rosary. The next scene, Our Lady of Sorrows appeared along with our Lord on his way to Calvary. Then finally, they saw Our Lady of Mount Carmel, crowned Queen of Heaven and Earth, appearing in a glorious vision, holding the child Jesus near her heart. Interestingly, these three scenes, the joyful vision of the Holy Family, the passion of Christ and his sorrowful mother, and the crowning of Our Lady of Mount Carmel, perfectly reflect the joyful, sorrowful, and glorious mysteries of the Rosary, which Our Lady spoke of in each of her apparitions. Taking a step further, these scenes of the Holy Family also mirror the miracle of the sun, which started out as a wondrous vision, but then it appeared to plunge into the crowd, who suffered throughout the ordeal. And then finally, it returned triumphantly to light the way for the world. Once again, joyful, sorrowful, and glorious visions. Now contrast this with what has happened to the family in our world since Christ became man. We were given the Holy Family 2,000 years ago, through which comes our salvation. It is a family that all families can emulate on the path to heaven. After Our Lady's appearance at Fatima, the family began to suffer a great passion, which is only worsening today. It has been broken up, de-emphasized, decreased in size due to and left Dave's with all those problems, too numerous to mention here. But there is hope. The vision of Our Lady of Mount Carmel shows that she is our hope in these times. The Queen of Heaven is the one who will ultimately restore the family and bring the world back to her Son. So what other proof do we have that Our Lady is our hope, right here and now? Let's go to Genesis chapter 3, verse 15, quote, "And the Lord God said to the serpent, I will put enmities between thee and the woman, and thy seed and her seed. She shall crush thy head, and thou shalt lie in wait for her heel," end quote. The Catholic Church has always taught that this woman of Genesis, who is also the woman of the Gospel of John, and the woman of Revelation, is none other than the Blessed Virgin Mary. God is using Our Lady to crush the head of Satan in these end times, and we are part of her heel when we heed her message at Fatima. Soon Our Lady will begin this great reversal in the battle against principalities and powers, as St. Paul put it, and in the end, her Immaculate Heart will triumph, as she specifically said at Fatima. So how do we assist Our Lady in the crushing of the head of Satan? Simple. We heed her message of Fatima. A summary of this message is at the top of the card that was given to you when you came in. Number one, Our Lady specifically asked us to stop offending God. Number two, receive the sacraments regularly. That includes confession, which has become a lost sacrament in recent years. Number three, we need to pray the Holy Rosary every day. The symbolism of the supernatural events of October 13, 1917 were all about the Rosary. The Rosary is nothing less than a gift from Our Lady that leads to better knowledge of the mysteries of Christ and an increased love for Him. And it is the weapon in our spiritual battle against sin and Satan. Number four, consecrate yourself to Our Lady's Immaculate Heart. You can do this on your own, or you can join us at St. Teresa's when we kick this off on November 3rd. The consecration process sets you apart from Our Lady to become, sets you apart for Our Lady to become part of her spiritual army. Number five, practice the first five Saturday in reparation. The back of the card tells you how to do this. Our Lady promises to assist us with the grace we need at the hour of death if we do this. The devotion also makes reparation for our sins. Number six, make sacrifices for sinners. This is so important. Our Lady asked the children to pray very much for sinners because, quote, many souls go to hell because there is no one to sacrifice and pray for them, end quote. Examples of sacrifices are fasting, good works, offering up small or large sufferings, and most importantly, an offering of our daily duties based on our state in life, married, single, or religious. In summary, the miracle of the sun and all the visions of Fatima were a warning to mankind from heaven. But heaven has given us the remedy. Our remedy is the beautiful woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. St. Louis de Montfort said, and I quote, "In the end times, Mary will produce the greatest saints of the church that she herself will form and educate. This is understandable, since she was able, in collaboration with the Holy Spirit, to produce the greatest work that any human creature is able to do, the God-man Jesus. Mary, therefore, is necessary for our salvation," end quote. I repeat, Mary, therefore, is necessary for our salvation. Let us therefore become the saints of these end times for our Holy Mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary, by heeding her call at Fatima. Our Lady of Fatima, pray for us.
Pray.